أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
لله نحمده ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، فاعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، I was told that a member from this community passed away. Our beloved brother Bashara, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him. And I'd like to say to the family and to the brothers who knew this brother that this is the way of life. We're all riding this train of life, and when your station comes, when your stop comes, you must get off. And subhanallah, the messenger of Allah said, when you are hit with similar calamity and musibah, he said, إِذَا أَصَاءَ إِذَا أُصِيبَ أَحَدُكُمْ أَوْ أَحَدُكُمْ بِمُصِيبَةٍ. He said, one of you, when he is hit with similar musibah, he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلْيَذْكُرْ مُصَابَهُ بِي. Let him remember the musibah that the ummah faced it when the messenger faced it, when the messenger of Allah died. He says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنَّهَا أَعْظَمُ الْمَصَائِبِ. It was indeed the greatest of all musibah, all calamity. So, ikhwati fillah, there is nothing is more painful for a mu'min than the memory of the messenger of Allah passing away and dying. لذلك قال القائل اصبر لكل مصيبة وتجلدي واعلم بأن المرء غير مخلدي فإذا أتتك مصيبة تشجع بها فاذكر مصيبتك بالنبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, be tough when you are faced with musibah. When you are faced with someone of your family member that Allah called him or her back, he said, تجلد, be strong. And remember, everyone in this life will leave it and will depart from it. And then he said, if you are hit with such a musibah and you think you cannot handle it, فتذكر Remember the musibah that the ummah faced when the messenger of Allah died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ikhwati fillah, I want to see if I can take you with me. I want to see if we can all leave this city that we're in. Forget about the masjid. Forget that you are here. And let us all travel together. Let us take this trip, magical trip. Let us see if we can all go and travel to this simple city, the city of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us see if we can all imagine the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the love that they had for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just to give you a glimpse or a drop of the love that they had for the Messenger of Allah is the incident when Abu Bakr came to the Messenger of Allah the day that Rasulullah and the Sahaba went back to the city of Mecca. And then Abu Bakr dragging his old father, Abu Quhafa, says to him, Ya Rasulullah, my father wants to give you a bay'ah. Then the Messenger of Allah said, why didn't you leave the old man? Let him be where he was and we will come to him. قَالَ لَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ He should come to you. He's an old man. He's a blind man. He cannot be by himself. And the Messenger of Allah saying, لَا يَا He's saying, let me go to him. And Abu Bakr saying, no. He should come to you. And then Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu, after his father accepted Islam, he walked with his father and he cried. And the people assume that Abu Bakr is crying for some other reasons. فَقَالَ لَهُ النَّاسُ So the people said to him, Ya Abu Bakr, why would you cry for such a beautiful day, such a joyful day for the mu'mineen? You know what he said, Ya Ikhwati Fillah? He said, I wish if this man, and he pointed to his father, if this man was Abu Talib, because Rasulullah would be more happier if Abu Talib was alive and he accepted Islam. Subhanallah. Imagine a man who's saying, you know, forget about my father. Look, I want to make Rasulullah so happy that I wish this man was Abu Talib because Rasulullah would be so pleased to see Abu Talib becoming a Muslim rather than my father. He was willing to sell his father to see Rasulullah smiling, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani, subhanallah. When you see the love that they have for the sake for the Messenger of Allah, and that they only care what how he feels, what makes him happy, what he loves, what he likes, what he dislikes. He knew if Abu Talib was still alive and he becomes a Muslim, that Rasulullah would be the most happiest man. And Thawban, his servant, Ya Ikhwati Fillah, gets up in the middle of the night and he cries. And then he comes to in the morning and Rasulullah is there and he comes to the Messenger of Allah crying. قَالَ مَا يُبْكِيكَ He said, Ya Rasulullah, I missed you last night. I thought about you and I missed you. قَالَ أَيُبْكِيكَ هَذَا Is that why you're crying? Ya Thawban. He said, not only that, O Messenger of Allah, but I remember when we all die. And you go to Jannah, Firdaus al-A'la, and I don't know where I'm going to see you or not. So I felt sorry for myself and I missed you for the fear that I will not be able to see you in the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say anything until Allah revealed this ayah. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصِّدِّقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. And then, only then, لعلي, only then رضي الله عنه, he felt comfortable. Only then, يا إخوتي في الله. Now, يا إخوتي في الله, we never met the Messenger of Allah. We never served him. We never shook his hand. We never did anything for him. Yet, we never got up in the middle of the night and cried for the fear that we would miss him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We never said to ourselves, what if Messenger of Allah goes to Firdaus al-A'la and I go somewhere else? The last incident, ya ikhwati fillah, from the love of the Sahaba, or the last two incidents, is the incident of Sawad radiyallahu anhu. In one of the battles, Rasulullah is lining up the soldiers and he's saying, Stowu, stretch your lines before you meet your enemy. And then subhanallah, Sawad bin Aziyya radiyallahu anhu, he stood where he was and the Messenger of Allah said, yeah, Sawad, go back. But he did not go back right away. He stepped back and he stood still out of line. So the Messenger of Allah with his stick, he pushed him back. And then he said, ouch, ya Rasulullah, you hurt me. You hurt me. And Allah sent you with the truth. Give me my haqq. So the Messenger of Allah gave him the stick and he said, do the same to me. Qala ya Rasulullah, but my skin was exposed. My skin was exposed. So the Messenger of Allah left his garment so he can hit him. And then Sawad, he hugged him and kissed him. And he said, ya Sawad, why did you do this? He said, ya Rasulullah, I'm not sure you see what you see. I'm not sure if I will ever see you again. فَأَرَدْتَ أَنْ يَكُونَ مَسَّ جِسْمِكَ آخِرُ عَهْدِكَ. I wanted to know, I wanted to be the last thing that I touch in this world is your skin, O Messenger of Allah. I would just want to touch your skin before I die. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ikrimah, look Ikrimah, the man, subhanallah, Ikrimah bin Abi Jahl, the man whose father fought the Messenger of Allah, the man who was fighting the Messenger of Allah until Rasulullah conquered the city of Mecca. In the Battle of Qadisiyah, when in Sahat al-Dain lam tukhinna dhakira, when he was going there at night, he woke up and he said to the Sahaba, I saw Rasulullah in my dream, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the interpretation of that dream is, I am going to die today. And he went back to his tent and he made ghusl. And he came out. And then he wore his kafan and he came, said to the Sahaba, to the people, what should I say if I meet the Messenger of Allah today? And the Sahaba, they wept and they said, Balliqhu anna salam. Give him our salam. Because when we die, the souls of the Salihin will meet the souls of the Salihin. So they say, if you meet the Messenger of Allah, give him our salam. Now, which one of us, ya ikhwati fillah, have that love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba loved the Messenger of Allah. At the same time, most of them never paid attention to the ayat that was giving indication that he will die like anyone else. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ إِنْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ. Muhammad is nothing but another messenger like the messengers before him. If he dies or kill, will you go back on your heels? The Sahaba, they read this ayah, but they never paid attention to the point that they thought that Rasulullah will die one day. In another ayah, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Az-Zumr, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتْ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. You indeed will die, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they will die as well. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. He said, we never allow any bashar to live forever before you. If you are dead, if you die or you kill, would they live forever? The answer is no. But the Sahaba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were more concerned about being with the Messenger of Allah, and they put this ayat in the back of their mind, never imagined that the Rasulullah would die before them. Some of the ahadith, ya ikhwati fillah, of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يقول أنس رضي الله عنه, and we'll only take from the days after حجة الوداع. He said رضي الله عنه, جابر بن عبد الله said, I saw the Messenger of Allah stoning on his camel, saying to the people, خذوا عني مناسككم, take your rituals from me, فلعلي لا أحج بعد حجتي هذه. Take your rituals for me. Indeed, I may never make hajj after this hajj. I may never make hajj after this hajj. And then the Messenger of Allah came back. He came back, and the Sahaba thought, Alhamdulillah, we conquered the city of Mecca. We are victorious. Now we can enjoy the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then, ya ikhwati fillah, one of the Sahaba said, one of the servants of the Messenger of Allah, Abu Muwayhiba. Wal hadithu fi musnadi Ahmad, wal tabarani wal hakim, wa sahahahu al hakim, wa wafaqahu al dhahabi, wa qala ala shirti sahih muslim. Yaqul, the Messenger of Allah called me in the middle of the night. فَقَالَ يَا أَبَا ثُوَيْبٍ يَا أَوَا مُوَيْهِبًا, Allah has ordered me to go and visit the people of Al-Baqi'. Come with me. So they went together. So the Messenger of Allah, he prayed and made dua for the people of Al-Baqi'. And then he told them, Allah has saved you from the trials of this dunya. Indeed, the gates of the fitan are approaching, and the people will be tested day and night. And he turned to him and he said, Ya Aba Muwayhiba, Inna Allah khayyarani, Allah gave me the option to live forever until the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. And he gave me the keys of this dunya, ثُمَّ الْجَنَّةِ, and then I will go to paradise. Or to meet my Lord, فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, choose the first one, take the keys of this world, and live forever and then paradise. قَالَ لَا وَاللَّهِ, I will not choose that. I will choose to meet my Lord. And then Aisha said, radiyallahu anhu, shortly after that, the Messenger of Allah came back from a janazah in Al-Baqi'ah. And after he came back, he came to my house. فَقُلْتُ آه وَرَاسَهُ, on my head. And then the Messenger of Allah said, no. بَلْ أَنَا وَرَاسَهُ. He said, no, I should say, on my head. This is the first time that the Messenger of Allah felt actual pain of the beginning of this illness. From this, the condition of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was getting worse and worse and worse. And then Al-Abbas radiyallahu anhu, or before that, when he started getting ill, Messenger of Allah keep asking his wife, where am I gonna be tomorrow? And finally, when he was at the house of Maymuna, he said, call all my wife for me. So all the wives came. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, allow me to stay in the house of Aisha. In the house of Aisha. So they all gave him the permission and he stayed in the house of Aisha, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Ali and Al-Fadl radiyallahu anhu literally carried him from the house of Maymuna to the house of Aisha. Now this is the only time that the Sahaba realized how sick was the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now the Ansar became very concerned. So Al-Abbas was passing by the group of the Ansar crying. قَالَ مَا يُبْكِيكُمْ, why would you cry? قَالُوا تَذَكَرْنَا, we remember مَجْلِسَنَا مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, we remember how we used to sit with the Messenger of Allah. And now he's ill and we cannot be with him. And then the Messenger of Allah, when he heard about this from Al-Abbas, he said, take me to the minbar. Take me to the minbar. And he went to the minbar. فَقَالَ يَا بِلَالْ, O Bilal, bring everyone. So the people came. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be good to the Ansar. Indeed, they did what they're supposed to be doing. They do responsibility. قَالُوا فَقَدْ قَضُوا مَا عَلَيْهِمْ, they did what they're supposed to be doing. وَبَقِيَ مَا لَهُمْ, and what is left is their haqq. When one of them does good, accept that goodness from him. And one of them does bad, forgive them. And then the Messenger of Allah said, كما في صحيح حديث أبي سعيد الخدري, he said, Allah gave the servant of his two options, to remain in this dunya or to choose out which with Allah subhanahu, which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَبَكَى أَبَا بَكْرٍ, because he chose, قَالَ فَاخْتَارَ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, he chose that which was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَبَكَى أَبَا بَكْرٍ, Abu Bakr cried. فَقُلْنَا, Abu Sa'id said, انظروا إلى هذا الشيخ, look at this old man, look at this man. The Messenger of Allah is informing us about a man whom Allah gave him two options, and he chose to be with his Lord. فَقَالَ أَبُو سَعِيدَ الْخُدَرِي فَكَانَ أَبُو بَكْرَ أَفْقَهَنَا, أَبُو بَكْرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ was the most knowledgeable among us. إخوتي في الله, after this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became very ill, and he was not able to come to the salah. فَقَالَ لِعَائِشَ, first, he called Bilal. فَقَالَ صَلُّوا بِالنَّاسِ, let the people pray. Bilal, he looked around and he found عمر بن الخطاب فقال يا عمر صلي بالناس lead the salah. عمر being جهوري very loud, he said Allahu Akbar. When the messenger of Allah heard the takbir of Umar, he opened his eyes and he says يَأْبَ اللَّهُ وَالْمُسْلِمُونَ إِلَّا أَبَا بَكْرٍ. Allah and his messenger, Allah and the Muslims refuse anyone to lead them in salah except Abu Bakr. And then after that salah, Rasulullah said to Aisha, Ya Aisha, مُرْمُرُ أَبَا بَكْرٍ فَلْيُصَلِّ بِالنَّاسِ. Order Abu Bakr and let him lead the salah. فقالت Aisha, يا رسول الله أبو بكر رجل رقيق. He's very gentle man. لا يسمع من وراه. People behind him cannot hear the recitation of Abu Bakr. And Abu Bakr كان رجل بكاء. When he says Allahu Akbar, his heart was not like our heart. That doesn't move. When the Quran is recited, nothing moves here. But Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, when he says Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, he start crying. He would start crying. She said, Ya Rasulullah, Mur Umar. He's big, he's loud, and people can't respect her hesitation. Qala la, Muru Abu Bakr. Let Abu Bakr lead the salah. She insists for the third time, no. Let Abu Umar lead the salah. No, let Abu Bakr. حتى قال إن كنا صواحب يوسف. You're playing the tricks that the women played against Yusuf alayhi salam. Let him lead the salah. So from that day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed Abu Bakr to lead the salah. Now after that, ya ikhwati fillah, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم came once, only once. Only once. قال النبي أصلى الناس. Did the people pray? They said no. He said, bring me 7 containers of cold water. Fresh water, untouched water. So they did. He said, pour it over me. So they did until he said enough. And then he tried to get up, but he fainted sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he opened his eyes. قَالَ أَصَلَّ النَّاسِ. Then people prayed. They said no. He said, pour more water over my head. And he did this 3 times. And finally, he came and he led the salah. And he sat on the minbar. He sat on the minbar first. When he sat on the minbar, ikhwati fillah, when he led and he sat on the minbar, then he said to everyone, if I ever did anything to you, please come and ask for. If I ever took any of your wealth, please claim it. And in the time, and he keep giving the ummah nasayih after nasayih until the time came for salat al-dhuhr. And then he sat back on the minbar sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he repeated the same thing until one man said, Ya Rasulullah, 3 dirhams. Qala ya fadl, pay the man. To make a long story, we all know they serve the messenger of Allah, ya ikhwati fillah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got seriously ill. And one of those days, Monday, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he lifted the curtain and he looked at the musallin. And his face showed that he's getting better. And he smiled at them. And the mu'mineen who were praying, ikhwati fillah, when they saw the messenger of Allah lifting the curtain and Abu Bakr is leading the salah, they almost got distracted by this, and Abu Bakr started moving back from the mihrab أنا رسول الله said مكانك مكانك. The Sahaba finished that salah, assuming that the Messenger of Allah is getting better and better and better. And then after the salah, everybody went their own business. Abu Bakr wanted the Messenger of Allah, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, allow me to go and visit my wife who lives outside of the city limit. So Rasulullah said, it's yours, go and visit. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leaned on Aisha, sat back, and Abdul Rahman bin Abu Bakr walked in with Miswak. And then sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he looked at it because he couldn't speak. It was that fast from Salat al-Fajr to this point that he could not speak. So Aisha said, would you like the miswak? And he said, he nodded, yes. Aisha, she took the miswak and she chewed the mess for the Messenger of Allah and she gave it to him. And then the Messenger of Allah started using the miswak with force. And with force, like, I'm meeting my Lord. This is the time that I should, alhamdulillah, prepare myself. And then, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he starts saying, بَلْ رَفِيقُ الْأَعْلَى. No, I want that can be with the companions, the Most High. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started giving the nasayih to the people by saying, استوصوا بالنساء خيرا. Allah, Allah في النساء. Three things that he concentrated at this moment, يا إخوتي في الله. One is a salah. Two is how we should treat our wives. Three, servants. وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ. And then the soul of the Messenger of Allah left the body. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he passed away, when the soul left the body, Aisha radiyallahu anha did not say much. She cried. Umar bin Khattab and Al-Mughira bin Shu'ba radiyallahu anhum ask for permission. So Aisha allowed them to walk in. Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu anhu, he thought Rasulullah is resting. But Al-Mughira, he went closer to the Messenger of Allah and he did not say anything until they both stood up and turned. And when they gave their backs to the Messenger of Allah, قال يا عمر أتدري أن رسول الله قد مات. Do you know that the Messenger of Allah died? Umar bin Khattab, he pushed him and said, إِنَّكَ مُرُونَ تَسُوسُهُ الْفِتْنَةِ. You a man who is a source of fitna. Rasulullah never died. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now Umar radiyallahu anhu wanted to confirm the situation and he confirmed that the news came to him that the Messenger of Allah died. And this is when he radiyallahu anhu drew his sword and went to the masjid. فقال إن الناس إن بعد المنافقين يزعمون. Some of the منافقين are claiming that the Messenger of Allah died. ووالله, he did not die. He went to Allah like Musa went to Allah. And when he comes back, he will cut the hands and the feet of the منافقين who claim that he died. And the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, there were different categories. One category believed the same thing that Umar believed, radiyallahu anhu. So they came with Umar and they say it's true. Other Sahaba, like Jabir said, radiyallahu anhu, they start walking aimlessly, not knowing a direction that they're going, just walking. Third category of the Sahaba, they didn't know what to do, like Uthman bin Affan, and they just sat down. They didn't know what to do with the news of the Messenger of Allah's death. They just sat down. And then Abu Bakr as-Siddiq came, radiyallahu anhu, on his horse, and he walked to the house of Aisha. And then he uncovered the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says, Subhanallah, the only death that Allah has decreed for you, you have tasted, O Messenger of Allah. And you will never see any hardship after this. And he kissed his forehead, and the tears were dropping from the eyes of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, and he covered him, and he went to the masjid. فقال على رسلك يا عمر. Oh Umar, relax. Calm down. Umar did not listen to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He's still talking, continue talking, saying, من قال إن محمد قد مات. Whoever says Muhammad died, wallahi, I will kill him. حتى عمر أبو بكر walked away رضي الله عنه فقال يا أيها الناس من كان يعبد محمدا فإن محمدا قد مات. O people, whosoever used to worship Muhammad, Muhammad indeed is dead. ومن كان يعبد الله, and whoever used to worship Allah, فإن الله حي لا يموت. Allah is ever living. And then he recited, وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل. يقول سعيد بن المسيب يقول عمر رضي الله عنه والله, when Abu Bakr recited the ayah, I thought this ayah was revealed right on the spot, as though this ayah was never in the Quran. And then he said, my feet could not carry me. He went down رضي الله عنه. Now the news is in the city. Women are crying, men are crying, children are crying. And when Abu Bakr recited this ayah, the people in the masjid repeated the ayah, and they walked to the city. They walked out of the masjid repeating the ayah, and whoever hears them repeating that ayah, they will repeat the ayah again until almost everyone start repeating the ayah. Now, subhanallah, ya ikhwati fillah. I think the most touching moment and the most painful moment was when Bilal radiyallahu anhu, when Abu Bakr requested from Bilal to call the adhan. And Bilal, this man, he loved the Messenger of Allah so much that he is with him all the time. At the time of jihad, he's with him. When he's eating, he's with him. When he's making wudu, he's with him. At the time of salah, he's his muadhin. When he's traveling, he's with him. When he was in the Kaaba, inside the Kaaba, he was with him, radiyallahu anhu. He was a son. They were like a son and a father. Like a son and a father. Not biological son, but like a son and a father. They were like a student and a sheikh, brother and his younger brother. Never they were away from one another. Subhanallah. And then Abu Bakr calls Bilal. And he says, Ya Bilal, adhin linnas. Oh Bilal, call the adhan. And with that beautiful voice, Bilal started calling Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And the people of the city of Medina, radiyallahu anhum, they remember the Messenger of Allah being in the masjid and part of the masjid. And then the Bilal radiyallahu anhu said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And the people repeated after him the shahada. And then Bilal radiyallahu anhu said, وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدُ Rasulullah. But the first one was difficult. The second one was almost next to impossible. Because all he could remember was Rasulullah walking out of that room with a beautiful smile, fit, standing, saying to Bilal, Ya Bilal, arihna biha. Ya Bilal, comfort us with the salah. He can only envision that, he can only see that, he can really see that vividly in his head. But there's no messenger of Allah, Rasulullah is not coming out of that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's not coming out of the room. People of Medina, ya ikhwati fillah, cry. Women and children, men came to the masjid, hoping perhaps that miracle may take place. And Rasulullah, in a very mysterious way, he will just walk out of the room and he will say, Ya Bilal, aqim as-salah. But subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never came out of that door. Yaqulu Anas bin Malik, yaqulu the most brightest day and the most beautiful day, or Jabir, was the day that Rasulullah walked into the city of Medina. And the most darkest day and the most difficult day was the day that the Messenger of Allah died. Qala wallahi, ma dafannahu hatta ankarna qulubana. He said, wallahi, we did not bury him except that we rejected our own hearts. We're no longer the same without the Messenger of Allah. We're no longer that mu'mineen have the same feeling when we used to be with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ikhwati fillah. Now, living these moments with the Messenger of Allah are not easy. Remembering Rasulullah, this moment, not easy. But what is the lesson from this? Is it just another story, incident that we already know? La ya ikhwati fillah. Listen to the wasaya of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave the nasayih and he said, number one, do not allow a mushrik to be in the Arabian Peninsula. No mushrik, no other religion should exist in that area. Second, he said, Ya ikhwati fillah, treat the delegation who used to come to me as I used to treat them. So you have non-Muslim group coming to the masjid, then we should treat them like Rasulullah used to treat the Christians. Let them sit in the masjid. Let them be in the masjid. Let them have their own meeting in the masjid, and so on. And then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, pray, be careful about your salah. Allah, Allah fi salah. Your salah. Now, Messenger of Allah is dying. His soul is almost leaving and departing from his body. And his wasiyah to you is, and I, be careful with your salah. Because if you really maintain your salah, nothing else would matter. Your iman would be strong. When the Shaykh, subhanallah, have you ever prayed behind Shaykh Sudais? I'm sorry, Shurain. Wallahi, one of the brothers, he said, when Shaykh Shurain recites a Fatiha, he said, wallahi, people in the haram, the one who's making tawaf during the month of Ramadan, and the one who is still getting, wallahi, he said, their heart, they move, and sometimes they cry. Why? Because the imam, the sheikh himself, his heart is the heart of a mu'min. When he recites from his heart. Now, when you and I are praying, and nothing, there's no wetness in our cheeks, there's no tears coming down, it's simply because we did not maintain, nor we follow the wasiyah of Rasulullah concerning the salah. We just pray dry salah, mechanical salah, movement, ruku' and sujood and qiyam, and there's nothing else. So Allah, Allah fi salah. The other nasiha that he gave you, ikhwati fillah, the fourth nasiha, is how we treat our wives and sisters. How we should treat them. We sometimes neglect them. We don't give them their rights. We treat them like a furniture in the house. And this is not right. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال استوصوا بالنساء خيرا استوصوا بالنساء خيرا. He said, treat women well. Treat them good. And he said, overlook their mistakes. And then the fifth, يا إخوتي في الله وما ملكت أيمانكم. If a slavery ever exists in a Muslim world, or if he exists wherever you from, then number one, we must treat them خير. Must treat them well, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people who hear the statement, the haqq, and apply it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us the khair that we present and make us among the people who have witnessed the Messenger of Allah and be with him on his hawd. Wallahu a'la wa a'lam wa jazakum Allahu khair.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم